Assalamualaikum warahmatullahi wabarakatuh. Good afternoon, students. Now we will learn about offers and suggestions. Before we start our lesson, please let me introduce myself. Yeah, my name is Pak Beni Sabtianto, and I was born in Pati Regency on January 12, 1994, and I live in Semarang City, Central Java, Indonesia. My background of education is UGRIS for my Bachelor of English Language Education, and then I continue my study in Open University as Bachelor of Elementary School Teacher, and the last is in UNES, Master of English Language Education. And you can contact me via Facebook, Instagram, YouTube, or my WhatsApp number. Okay, in this chapter, for the core competency or kompetensi dasar is menerapkan fungsi sosial, struktur teks, dan unsur kebahasaan teks interaksi transaksional, lisan dan tulis yang melibatkan tindakan memberi dan meminta informasi terkait saran dan tawaran sesuai dengan konteks penggunaannya. Perhatikan unsur kebahasaan should, can, dan lain sebagainya. Kemudian pada kompetensi dasar untuk nilai keterampilan, yaitu kalian diminta untuk dapat menyusun teks interaksi transaksional, lisan dan tulis, pendek dan sederhana, yang melibatkan tindakan memberi dan meminta informasi terkait saran dan tawaran dengan memperhatikan fungsi sosial, struktur teks, dan unsur kebahasaan yang benar dan sesuai dengan konteks. Now, please observe these pictures. For pre-activity conversation 1 with a partner, read the conversation given below. Hi John. Hi Jen. What are you doing? Nothing much. Would you like to go to the movies? I would love to, but not right now. How about in the afternoon? Great. What movie do you want to watch? Let's watch Spring. I would rather not. I am not much into horror movies. How about Peanuts? Okay, let's go. When do you want to go? 4 o'clock show. It sounds good. Okay, see you then. Okay, see you. Okay, from this example of the dialogue, what kind of interpersonal transaction is going on in the conversation given beside? Next, we continue observe conversation 2. Hello Jen. Hi Siti. You look tired. What is going on? I am working on my project paper. It is due tomorrow. I don't think I will be able to finish it. Would you like any help? Yes, please. I would really appreciate it. Tell me what I can do and I will start right away. Thank you, you are an angel. What kind of interpersonal transaction is going on in the conversation given beside? Now we move building blocks. Suggest means to give a suggestion that is not introduced or proposed, an idea or a plan for someone's consideration. It means suggest. Suggestion is different with suggest. Suggest is as a verb, but suggestion is as noun. Suggestions are abstract and can be in form of solution, advice, plan, and idea. It can be accepted or refused. And then, what is the social function of suggestion? The social function of suggestion to facilitate interpersonal communication between different people. And then, for example, let's finish our homework first. Let's go home. Now we move expression suggestion. There are a lot of expression suggestion like let's blah blah blah. Why don't we could, how about I suggest that you might want to change, I think, I don't think, and so on. For example, you can look at the screen expressing suggestion. There are asking suggestion and giving suggestions and some examples. Number one, for asking suggestions, do you have any suggestion for me? If you want to give suggestion to your friend or to other people, you can express like this example. You should plus verb one. So is there are a lot of model that you use, but you have to remember that model always followed by verb one. For example, you should do best thing for your better future. Number two, would you mind giving me your suggestion? Or if you want to give suggestion, you can use this expression. You had better plus verb one. Example, you had better to stay at home than go outside. Number three, can you tell me what I should do? You can give your suggestion like you want to go to cinema than shopping center. What should I do? I suggest you to blah blah blah. For example, I suggest you to be an army than civil servant. Number five, what is the best way to solve this problem? How about plus verb ing? Yes, you know that verb ing is known as gerund. Gerund in bahasa Indonesia means kata kerja yang dibendakan. So the function of gerund is noun as a subject. Jadi kata bendanya itu sebagai subjek. Subjek itu adalah pelaku. For example, how about going to the beach? Next, number six, do you have any ideas? Let's blah blah blah. For example, let's go to a movie. You know that if you want to use let's, it is always followed by verb one. The verb one in this example is go. And then number seven, any idea? Why don't you blah 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 followed by verb one? Why don't we go to a movie? Can you give me some advice about blah blah blah? If you want to give suggestion, you can use this expression. Couldn't you go outside? Nah, after you've learned about expression suggestion, now how to respond the suggestion? There are two types of responding suggestion. The first is accepting suggestion and the second is refusing suggestion. You can use this expression for responding suggestion. Sure, okay, yes, let's. Yes, I'd like to. Yes, I'd love to. What a good idea. Why not? Yes, please, sir. That sounds like a good idea. That's good, or that's nice, or that's wonderful idea. But if you don't like, or if you want to refuse somebody's suggestion, you can say, no, let's not. No, I'd rather not. I don't feel like it. I dislike your suggestion. What an awful, or what a bad idea. I don't think it's a good idea. Sorry. Or you can say, sorry, that's boring. Let's do anything else. It's a bad idea. I'm afraid we can't, or I can't, blah blah blah. Blah blah blah, you can follow by your argument or your opinion why you refuse somebody's suggestion. Now in building blocks, we move in offer. Offer means to give something physical or abstract to someone, which can be taken as a gift or a treat. Yeah. Offer itu berarti untuk memberikan sesuatu. Offer berarti untuk memberikan sesuatu secara fisik atau abstrak yang tidak bisa kita pegang kepada seseorang yang bisa diambil sebagai hadiah atau perdagangan. Now, offer can be given in term of food, money, solutions, friendship, or a bargain. It can be taken or refused. Jadi yang namanya offer itu bisa diberikan dalam bentuk makanan, uang, solusi, persahabatan, atau penjualan, tawar-menawar. Jadi itu bisa diambil atau ditolak yang namanya offering. What is the social function of offer? It is the same with suggestion. It is to facilitate interpersonal communication between different people. Now look at two examples below. Shall I take you home? Bolehkah saya mengantarkanmu pulang? Do you want eating something? Kamu mau makan sesuatu? Nah, and now we can learn about expressing offer. There are a lot of expressing offer. The first one like, may I, bolehkah saya? Can I, dapatkah saya? Atau bisakah saya? Shall I, bolehkah saya? Akankah saya? And would you, blah blah blah, would you mind, would you like, and anything. Number five, how about, for examples, may I give you a hand? Bolehkah saya memberimu bantuan? Can I help you? Bisakah saya membantumu? Shall I bring you something? Apakah saya bisa membawakanmu teh? Would you like another piece of cake? Maukah kamu potongan kue lain? How about I help you with this? Bagaimana kalau saya membantumu dengan ini? Can I clean the car for you? Bisakah saya membersihkan mobil untukmu? Shall I help you with your homework? Akankah saya atau bolehkah saya membantumu dengan tugasmu, PR-mu? I will do the washing if you like. Saya akan melakukan mencuci jika kamu mau. And now how to respond offers. Yeah. If you want making offer, you can use this expression like can I, shall I, would you like, how about, can I. But if you want to respond in positive offers or accepting offer, you can say yes please, I really appreciate it, thank you, it is very kind of you, yes please, that would be lovely, yes please, that would be very kind of you, thank you, thank you, I appreciate your help. And if you don't feel it is better or you don't want somebody give offer to you, you can decline it. So you can say, it is okay, I can do it myself. No thank you. No thanks. I don't want another helping. Don't worry, I will do it myself. That's alright, I will manage on my own. This is the responding to offers. If you want to say accept or decline somebody's offer. Now let's take a look at the sentence structure to offer something. You know there are a lot of modal verb like would, shall, could, will. Now the subject, yeah. Subject is pelaku yang melakukan like you, we, I, you. Object, would you care for another cup of tea? Shall we take you there? Could I offer you something? Will you have tea with that? Now, this is four examples sentence structure to offer something. You can separate with your own sentence. Now, in part C, you can practice this question. There are 10 questions you can answer. After you finish part C and then move in part B, there are some grammatical errors in the sentence And then you have to circle the mistake in each sentence. Then rewrite. If there are any mistakes, put a tick mark next to the sentence. Yeah. There are 10 questions, but one question have some mistakes. So you have to circle the mistake in each sentence. So you have to be carefully if you want to answer these questions. And part C, you have to respond to the suggestion and offer given below. Yeah, you just only respond. And in part D, active conversation, you have to use the thinking technique, think, pair, share, to offer and suggest a solution to the problem given below. You came to know that your friends had a fight. They are not on talking terms for some time now. Since you are a common friend, it is difficult for you because you want to hang out with both of them, but they can't stand each other. So you have to find a way to offer and suggest a solution so that the fight is over. Now, this is your task. After you answer part D, and then there is an essay exercise, number 1 until number 5. It is the question based on this conversation between Tony and Iwan. And then the last exercise is latihan pilihan ganda. There are 5 questions, number 1 until number 5. And you can open your books if you want to study more by these references. Kemdikbud in 2017 and 2019. And this is, I give you the link of YouTube for if you want to spread out your mind. Okay, thank you. Good afternoon.